Acetylcholinesterase consists of two parts. Globular head proteins that perform the enzyme activity and tail proteins that attach the head complex to the cell membrane. Let us look more closely at the active site of the head unit to see its interactions with acetylcholine and with insecticides. Here we see acetylcholine, the natural chemical that interacts with the enzyme. Acetylcholinesterase destroys acetylcholine by binding it to its enzymatic active site. The acetylcholine has a three-dimensional structure that fits into the active site of the enzyme like a key fits into a lock. The acetate group binds to the active site, and the choline group is split from the acetate. This destroys the neurotransmitter activity of the acetylcholine. After splitting off choline, the acetate group is released from the active site, and the enzyme is again free to bind and split more acetylcholine. Both organophosphate and carbamate insecticides mimic the structure of acetylcholine and fit into the active site of the acetylcholinesterase. Here we see how a representative organophosphate interacts with acetylcholinesterase. Like natural acetylcholine, the organophosphate molecule fits into the active site of the acetylcholinesterase. Part of the organophosphate is split away, leaving a bound residue, but unlike acetate, which was released, the organophosphate residue remains permanently bound to the active site. When the enzyme active site is tied up by the organophosphate residue, additional incoming acetylcholine cannot bind with the enzyme and continues to accumulate. In the case of the organophosphates, acetylcholinesterase activity is irreversibly destroyed. When a chemical such as an organophosphate insecticide binds to the active site of an enzyme and destroys the enzyme's activity, it is known as non-competitive inhibition.